Hello everybody, quick example of using Google Cloud Run to run a Flask Python app. And typically you'll see examples where people show you how to do it with Python on Heroku. One of the problems is as you use up more bandwidth, you have to add more, they're called dynos, and you have to scale it up. So there's potential for increased charges. And if you want to just experiment with Google, you can get $300 worth of credit, and then you can create a project in Google, Google Cloud Console, and then you get something like this. So I just wanted to really show this. It's a tutorial, and it's basically telling you how to, if we go back a couple of pages, you create a web service. So create and deploy a Cloud Run serverless service. So how can it be serverless? Well, it's running on, as you can see, uses Dockerfile and Kubernetes and so on. The tutorial shows how to get started with Cloud Run. You'll set up a Hello World service, deploy it to Cloud Run, and view the status of your live service resources. By the end of this tutorial, you'll understand how to create a sample Hello World Cloud Run service. So this is not so much about writing the code, it's about how to deploy it. And as I say, many examples and many books will always show you how to deploy on Heroku. So I just thought I'd just show that this is not the only way. You can also use Google Cloud. Edit and read the deploy service, and then you can look at the logs and so on. So so I've already gone to cloud code down here. So this is, if you're not, came as a bit of a surprise to me really, that Google Cloud uses pretty much the identical, I guess it's the Eclipse framework. And if you're used to VS Code, then editing and writing and employing code in Google is quite familiar. So then you do deploy to Cloud Run. You got Kubernetes or Cloud Run. And standard Flask project, Hello World server. To be honest, you don't need all of that. You could just do def hello function and the message is running. And here we've got server port. So it's just changing the default port to be port 8080. And app run debug equals force, port equals server port, which is 8080, and the host is, it's just telling it to run on the local machine, which is the it's the Google server, or the serverless server, the serverless service even. Sorry about that, I had a spam phone call. Right, so we've seen the code. Fairly standard. And yeah, so what you do is you just you create a new application and then you deploy it. So once it's deployed, the next thing is to edit it and redeploy it. So let's just have a go at that while we're here. And the service source code app.py implements the service behavior which responds to requests with our Hello World greeting. When directly invoked for local use, this code creates a basic web server that listens on the port defined by the port environment variable. This app is containerized via a Dockerfile. You can see the Dockerfile down there. From Python 3.8, working directory app, requirements txt, and so on. To modify and recompile your service, change your app.py message to it's redeployed. So let's have a go at that. And instead of it's running, redeployed. I'm guessing this has got autosave. Yeah, autosave is a nice feature if you're not used to using VS Code or having that option. Then autosave is, I think it's great. Change a py message, click on cloud code in the status bar and select deploy to cloud run. So although it says deploy, we're actually redeploying it and verifying APIs, fetching cloud run services, and it's deployed. Container image and so on. We've already got the if we just close some of these, otherwise it's getting a bit too congested here. We've already got the URL here from earlier. So let's try and just bring up that page this time. And there you see, provisioning your cloud shell machine, connecting to your shell instance. And I just need to refresh this. And it's what's gonna, oh, I dragged it, sorry. Navigate to Cloud Run Explorer. And choose View Logs. Show detailed logs. Ah, there's our URL. That didn't appear to change it, so right, let's try again. Deploy to I'm just going to close that. Close that. Deploy to cloud run. Okay, in service settings, check that. Yeah, that's the right one, I believe. And then click deploy. Did I not do that last time? I can't remember. There we go. I think that's looking more promising. Deploying, executing gcloud run deploy, gcloud command run deploy hello world. So all of these GUI instructions have all got command line equivalents. They typically begin with gcloud lowercase. And this, if we click on this now, it's redeployed. There we go. So the thing I missed there was actually when, let me just make it smaller, I forgot to go down to the bottom and actually click deploy. All I initially did was I clicked deploy to cloud run, but I didn't click on deploy. So yeah, there we go. So we've actually got that running, and that's running in the big wide world. So if you had that URL, you would actually be able to come and see this page. Yeah, so that's the old one. Apologies. That's the old one. That's the new one. So yeah, there we go. That's just a quick sort of whistle-stop tour of how to deploy a Python Flask project using Google Cloud Platform. And you don't have to use Heroku. If you do and you like it, that's fine. If you think it's better, drop me a comment. And yeah, let's get a discussion going about it. I'm not recommending either, to be honest, but I'm just showing an alternative. So if you like it, thumbs up. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video. Thank you. Bye.